Hey everybody, welcome to the Jayda and Stitches show. I love cute things, and since Valentine's Day is coming up, I thought I would make us a cute little gift bag, but not just any kind of gift bag. This one is a teddy bear. I've made this little teddy bear in a sweet vanilla flavor, and you can stuff it full of any kind of sweets that you may like and give it to someone you're sweet on. So without further ado, let's head to the craft table, get our hooks and yarn, and hook ourselves up a cute little teddy bear bag.
For our teddy bear drawstring bags, we're going to be using 4-ply worsted weight size 4 yarn. This is my main color in this nice sort of vanilla, and I'm going to need about 130 to 140 grams of that, so you should have about that much for the main part of your bag. And black and white in smaller amounts for accents, so you don't need too much of those. You're going to need some cording or ribbon for your drawstring, a pair of scissors, a yarn needle, and a 4.25 millimeter hook or G6. And that's all you need. Now we can get started. We're going to begin with a cinch circle. Into that circle, we're going to single crochet 8 times. Once you've got 8 single crochet built into your cinch circle, grab the short tail, cinch it shut, find the first single crochet you made, and you can slip your hook into that. We're not going to join, we're working in the round, so we're just going to crochet directly into that stitch. I'm going to work over my short tail, and into each stitch for round 2, we're going to work 2 single crochet. So at the end of row 2, you will have 16 single crochet stitches. If you count every single stitch all the way around, you should have 16. We're still increasing for row 3. We're going to work directly into the next stitch. Work 2 single crochets into that stitch. And 1 single crochet into the next stitch. And that's the pattern all the way around for row 3. 2 single crochet into the next stitch, 1 single crochet into the next stitch. You can repeat 2-1, 2-1 all the way around. At the end of row 3, you will have 24 stitches, so do a quick count all the way around. You should have 24 stitches. Row 4, we're still increasing, and now we're going to move from 24 stitches to 32. We're going to work 2 single crochet into the next stitch, and 1 single crochet into each of the next 2. And that's the pattern for row 4. 2 single crochet into the next stitch, single crochet into each of the next 2. Repeat, and by the end of this row, you'll have 32 stitches. At the end of row 4, you will have 32 stitches, so take a second, count all the way around, make sure you've got 32 showing. We're still increasing. We're going to move through row 5 to a total of 40 stitches, and that pattern is 2 single crochet into the next stitch, single crochet into each of the next 3. Two single crochet into the next stitch, single crochet into each of the next 3. And that's your pattern. I'll see you back at the beginning. At the end of row 5, you should have 40 stitches. Take a moment, count around. If you have 40, you're at the end. Now we're going to continue once more to increase. For row 6, we're going to work 2 single crochet into the next stitch, and a single crochet into each of the next 4. So 2 single crochet into the next stitch, single crochet into each of the next 4. Repeat, and once you get back to the beginning, you should have a total of 48 stitches. That is the end of row 6. You should have 48 stitches, and we're done increasing. So because we did 6 rows of increasing, we're going to add in 6 more single crochets. This doesn't change your stitch count. You're still going to have 48 stitches. I just want to even up the circle before we move on. So crochet once into each of the next 6 stitches. Now that we've evened up our circle, we're going to create a flat bottom for the rest of our drawstring bag to be built upon. To do that, we're going to slip stitch into the next stitch to close off our circle. So that's the bottom done. We're going to chain one, and now we're going to work around the post of every single stitch of the previous row. So this is the front side, or the right side, it's the side facing you. This is the wrong side, and you can see there's sort of like a bubbliness going on. Right side, wrong side. When we single crochet, typically you go from front to back through the stitch. In order to highlight the post of the stitch you want to work around, you do the opposite. You come from the back to the front through the very next stitch, go front to back through the stitch next to that, so it'll look something like this. And what that does is pop the post of the stitch out on top of your crochet hook. Single crochet as normal, and you've single crocheted around the post. I'm going to do that again. The next stitch that you start from back to front in is this one here that looks like it's lifted. It's coming up on an angle. Back to front through it. Front to back through the very next stitch. That pops the post out. Pull that yarn all the way back through and single crochet as normal. Once more, there's the next stitch that we start in. It's lifted. Back to front. Front to back through the next stitch. There's your post. Pull the yarn right through everything and single crochet. This is what it's doing. It's taking this chained edge of our last row and it's forcing it down. So it's going to create a flat edge for the rest of our bag to be built upon. Every single stitch going from here on out will sit on top of this pretty little flat edge. It's a nice definition, and it gives the bag something flat to sit on. You can continue to work around the post of every stitch. There it is again. You should still have 48 single crochet in your next row. So this is row 7. You should still have 48 single crochet at the end of row 7. We're not changing our stitch count anymore. And just take your time. Make sure you find each post. You don't want to skip any. Always start with that lifted stitch. And just work your way around. Once you get back around to the beginning, you'll be looking at something that looks a bit like a crossover. So just where you started, it kind of lifts. You should still have 48 stitches all the way around, and you're just going to continue working directly into that next stitch. So there's just going to be a little bit of a crossover, but don't worry, that's not going to show much towards the end of our project. So you should still have 48 stitches. We will have 48 stitches in every single row from here on out. And you are just going to single crochet in every single stitch all the way around. No joining of rows, we're working in the round. Just keep working around and around and around for a total. So a total, this is row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is the lift row, all the way up to row 21. Now you're just going to work single crochet in every stitch all the way around. And if it helps you, you can put a little safety pin or a stitch marker in this little area where the lift happens, and you can count rows all the way up from this point. You'll know when you've done 1 and then 2 and 3 and 4. You can mark that area if you can't readily see it. And that's how you count how many rows you've done. So remember, your lift row, this little row here that flips downward, that was row 7. We're on to row 8. Row 8 is the first row of single crochet that sits up proper on top of that flattened row. And you want to work single crochet all the way up to row 21. Just keep single crocheting in the round. At the end of row 21, and there's my start, I finish right above it there. This is how you count. So here's the bottom of row 7. You see how it turned downward for us. This is row 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 21 rows completed. Now we're going to finish off the row by slip stitching into the next stitch. And that is the base of our entire little bag, all done. Now we need a drawstring row. And we're going to switch from single crochet to half double crochet. So we're going to chain 2 to begin. That brings us up to the height of a half double crochet. We're going to half double crochet in the same stitch as joining, because we're actually going to ignore the chain 2. So the chain 2 doesn't really count as a stitch in this project. So ignore your chain 2. Your half double crochet in that same stitch as joining is the first stitch of this row. Half double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, skip a stitch, find the next one, and half double crochet into it. Half double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, skip a stitch, and half double crochet into the next stitch. And that's the pattern all the way around. Half double crochet into the first 2 stitches, chain 1, skip 1. Half double crochet into the stitch after that. So there's my one I'm skipping. I'm half double crocheting into the next one. And that's it. Half double crochet, half double crochet, chain 1, skip 1. Half double crochet, chain 1, skip 1. All the way around. And that will give us an eyelet row. Once you're back round at the beginning, you should finish with half double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, and there's the false stitch that the chain 2 comes out of. You're going to skip over top of that chain 2, find the top of the first real half double crochet that you made, and let's see, we'll back up, here it is here. Slip your hook in there, and slip stitch. That will push the two chains to the back, and leave you with a little bit of an opening, so you won't really see this once your drawstring goes through. And that is your drawstring row. Now we can fasten off because our little bag is complete. Cut yourself a little bit of tail. Just pull your yarn through there, give it a nice tight tug. Grab your yarn needle and you can weave your tail in across the back of your stitches on the inside of your little sack. We're now moving on to the inner ear part of our ears for our little teddy bear bag. I've already gone ahead and made one, and I'm using white for the inside of my ear. So, you're going to want to begin with a cinch circle. And after you've chained 1 to secure your circle, chain 1 more. This is a chain 2. It gives us the height of a half double crochet, but we're not counting it as a half double crochet. You want to work 9 half double crochets into your cinch circle, and remember to work over top of that little short tail, because that's what allows us to cinch the circle shut. So work over top of it. You want 9 half double crochets. Once you've worked 9 half double crochets into your cinch circle, grab your short tail and cinch it shut. We are not working in the round. So you're going to chain 1 to begin row 2, and flip your circle over. We're going to work backwards now. So that's your chain 1, Don't confuse it with a stitch. This is your first real stitch. You're going to single crochet into the first four stitches. That brings you to the fifth stitch. It's the middle. You're going to work two single crochets into that. And then single crochet into each of the last four stitches. This will give you a total stitch count of 10, and that's it for the inner ear. Once you're done, grab your scissors, snip your yarn, fasten off, and you can use your little yarn needle to weave in all of your ends. So you don't need any of your tails showing for your inner ear. This is the front of your inner ear. So it's the front of your single crochets that you're looking at. This is the back. You see that little bubbly bit? That's the back of your single crochets. So this will be the inside of your ear. So you can take your yarn needle, weave in your tails on the inside of your inner ear. We're on to the outer part of the ear now. It's basically built the same way as the inner. You're going to create a cinch circle, chain one more, and work 9 half double crochets into that cinch circle. Once you have 9, cinch your circle shut, chain one, spin your work, single crochet into the first 4 stitches. Work 2 single crochet into the 5th stitch. Single crochet into each of the last 4 stitches. And pause. We are not cutting our yarn. This is the front of your outer ear. So this is going to be the part that you see when you look at the back of your little teddy bear. That's the inner part, and that's where you see the sort of the bubbliness of that last row we did. You're going to chain one, spin your work so that you're looking at the inside or the wrong side of your ear. Pick up an inner ear, make sure this wrong side or the bubbly bit of the last row faces inward. Put the two wrong sides together, and now we're going to single crochet them together. So you're going to begin by putting your hook through the first stitch on the inner ear and then through the first stitch of the outer ear. And we're going to single crochet them together using this yarn, so the outer ear yarn, because we want a little bit of the outside color to show through to the front. So single crochet through that first pair of stitches. Work 2 single crochet into the next stitch. So pick up the stitches of both sides and work 2 single crochets into it. Single crochet into the next 2 stitches. So when I say 2, I mean both sets of both sides. Two single crochet into the next set. Single crochet once into each of the next 2 sets of stitches. Work 2 single crochet into the next set. And then single crochet into each of the last 2 sets. And that is your ear. We want to leave a nice long tail so that we can sew our ears to our teddy bear bags. fasten off. And you can take that short tail from the back of your ear and just tuck it up inside. You don't actually have to weave it in. Just tuck it up inside. And we don't need to stuff our ears. So you can just stuff up your little tiny tail, and that is the ear finished. We're going to put that one aside, and you're going to go ahead and finish off your second ear. All right, we're back to our accent color. We're going to make a little snout for our bear now. So we're going to begin with a cinch circle. We're going to use the single crochet stitch, so you only need that one chain to complete your circle. And work 6 single crochet into your cinch circle. Once you have 6 single crochet, cinch up your circle. We're working in the round. Find the first single crochet you made, work 2 single crochet into it, and in each stitch around, by the end of row 2, you'll have 12 single crochet. That's 12 single crochet at the end of row 2. We've got one more row of increase. We're going to work 2 single crochet into the first stitch, single crochet into the next stitch, and then 2, and 1. Oops. Work that pattern all the way around, and at the end of row 3, you'll have 18 single crochets. All right, we worked 3 full rows of increase, so we're going to work a single crochet into each of the next 3 stitches. You're still going to have 18 stitches, so this doesn't change your stitch count, it just makes your circle look a little rounder. And that's it! You can slip stitch into the next stitch, fasten off, but leave enough tail that you can sew your little snout to the front of your teddy bear bag. There we go. Now we're going to actually make it look like a snout. Cut yourself a length of black yarn. I've cut myself about 65 centimeters or a little over 3 feet. Pick up your snout piece so that the cut off tail hangs to the bottom. And we're going to begin by making his nose. So you're going to bring your yarn through the very center of your cinch circle. But don't pull it all the way. You want to leave a little bit of yarn left. You can put your finger on it so that you can knot everything off when you're done. So you can just hold it pinched between your thumb and forefinger. Make sure that long white tail is down here and it doesn't get tangled up while you're sort of embroidering. And now we're going to fill in the shape of a V. So we're going to go off on an angle in the first direction. Come back through the center. Don't pull too tight because you don't want to bend your little snout out of shape. You want it to stay relatively flat. Go off on an angle in the other direction, always going underneath the top of the stitch of the outside row, and then back through the center. You can start by working 3 stitches through each set of stitches. So 3 in this stitch, always coming back through the middle, 3 in this stitch, always coming back through the middle. So for example, I'll go back over here. This would be my second stitch. Always back through the middle. Don't pull too tight. And there's my third stitch. Depending on how thick your accent yarn is here, you may only need to work 2 if it's terribly thick, or you may need to make more than 3 stitches if it's really thin. Ideally, you want to fill in this V space so that you have what looks like a solid black nose. So you can put in as many stitches back and forth as you need to in order to get that effect. And once you're finished with the 2 outside parts of the V, you can start filling in all the middle parts. Once you've filled in at least 3 stitches, and you've got a nice thick nose part going here, you're going to notice that you've still got little gaps across the top, and that's where we fill in across the top. So now, instead of coming back up through the middle, wherever your last stitch finished, so long as it's not one of the ends, come in from the end, hop over to the middle stitch, and do that a couple times. Remember, don't pull too tightly. And that will fill in your nose. You can come out the other side and into the middle stitch. Do that a couple times. And that will fill in your nose. If you still have a couple of little gaps, then just repeat the process until all of those little gaps disappear. So here is our nose. Now we're going to bring our yarn back out through the center and we're going to put a little mouth on them. Make sure you don't, it's getting kind of thick back here, so make sure you still have a handle on that little short tail you started with. And we're going to do just a simple little split V in the opposite direction. So you're going to come down on a little angle. Here's where your bottom tail is. Just go one stitch to the side. Back up through the center. And then one stitch to the other side. There we go. Now you can flip it upside down. Knot your two black ends together and just trim it. You don't need to weave these tails in, because this is not going to show on the front of your snout. Next, we're moving on to the eyes. So grab your black accent yarn, and we're going to begin with a cinch circle. Into your cinch circle, you're going to work 8 single crochets. Once you have 8 single crochets worked into that cinch circle, cinch it up. Find the top of that first single crochet you made, and I know it's a bit difficult to see because I'm using black here, but you can find it on your own, just like all the other cinch circles we did. And you're going to slip stitch to it and fasten off. Remember, you want to leave as much tail as you think necessary that you can sew your eye to your little teddy bear bag. And then just fasten off. And that's it. Take your short tail, weave it in a few times across the back, and you want to make 2 of these. We now have all of our pieces necessary to complete our little bag. Grab your little sack, your little bag here, find the end, or the back where you fastened off. That's where your little chain two kind of wiggles around. That's going to be the back. So put your fingers on that, spin it around so that you've got an idea of where the exact back is. Come around to the sides. You can even sort of squish it together so that you're looking at your back being right in the middle. So there's my where I seamed off. Here's my sides. Take the first one, grab an ear, and if you need to pin it in place, you can do that, or you can sort of hold it in place like I do, and you want to just sew it down in a straight line down the side of your little bag so that it sits on the edge just like that. So you can grab your yarn needle, thread up that long tail you left, skip to the last row of single crochet. You don't want to interfere with your eyelet row. And that's where you're going to put your first stitch. As you work down the side of your bear bag, you want to make sure you go through both sides of your ear. So you want to make sure you get both sides of your ear because you don't want it sitting open. So all the way through. Pick up the next viable set of stitches, which is probably the row beneath it. And repeat. Make sure you get a piece of both sides of that ear. Stop every once in a while, make sure you're going in a straight line down, and just sew down the entire ear. Once you've sewn your entire ear down and you know it's not going to come off, take your yarn, push it through to the inside of your little bag. And on the inside, we're going to make a little knot. So you're going to just pick up a couple of stitches and then knot your yarn off once or twice, probably best to do it twice. And then you can weave your little tail in back and forth a few times across some of the insides of these stitches. And not only will your knot be on the inside of your bag, it'll be very small, and your tail will be tucked in back and forth on the inside of your bag. So that makes it nice and neat and tidy. And once you've got that all neatly done, grab your other ear, find the exact opposite side of your sack, and repeat the process by sewing on your second ear. Once we have our ears on, it is important to make sure that the inner ear is facing forward. We can put on our snouts. So thread up the tail on your snout and place it on your bag very close to the bottom or the chin edge of our bag. So you maybe want to work your first stitch in at the second row from the bottom. The reason for that is because we don't want to crowd our face to the top, because we want to put on our eyes still, and when our bag is cinched together, we don't want our face to look squished. So you do want to anchor your snout somewhere near the bottom of your bag. Pin it into place if you think it's necessary, or if you can sort of hold it down and eyeball it like I do. Then you can start by picking up, I like to work across the tops of stitches, and then pick up the whole stitch along the edge of your snout. And stop every so often to make sure that it's still straight. You don't want your crooked little snout showing. Or you don't want to get halfway around and realize that your snout is crooked. Pick up a piece or two of the next. Work the whole stitch of your snout. Pause, make sure it's straight. And continue that all the way around. Once you're finished sewing on the snout, you can do the same thing you did with the ears. Bring your yarn through to the inside of your bag, knot it on the back, weave it in a couple times, and trim off any excess. Once your snout's on, you can put on your eyes. Lay them down on your face, decide whereabouts you want them, pin them into place if necessary, and then sew them down exactly as you did for the snout. When you're finished, take the tails that are left, pull them through to the back, knot them off, weave them in a few times, and that's it for the face of our little teddy bear bag. Once your face is on, all we need to do is put in our drawstring. You want to start from the back, find your little chain two, and put your string through that chain one space next to it, and then just weave it in back and forth, in and out of all of those little chain one spaces that you made. You want to make sure that your drawstring is long enough that you have enough sitting outside of your bag when it's fully open that the string won't completely come undone or get sucked into the rest of your, you don't want it basically unraveling on you. So I've cut a length of cord here that's about 60 centimeters, I should say, yeah, 60 centimeters long, maybe about 2 feet. And there. Once you've got them all cinched up and full of sweets and candies and little notes and possibly even a stuffed animal or two, it will look like a nice big round bear head. And because of our flat bottom, he'll always sit nice and neat and tidy on his butt.
And there you go. One simple little drawstring teddy bear bag. You can fill it full of all sorts of lovely things for the person you are sweet on. And that's it for this week, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed making this with me. We will see you again very soon on the Jayda & Stitches Show. Until then, stay safe, stay crafty, and have a sweet week. Bye, everybody.